Good morning. Welcome again to Morning Devotions. Thank you for our time together. Please don't forget Wow God tonight at main campus, 7 o'clock. But right now, I want you to come back with me to the book of Acts chapter 16, beginning with verse 16. I want to talk to you about demons a little bit. One day, as we were going down to the place of prayer, we met a slave girl who had a spirit that enabled her to tell the future. Enabled her to tell the future. So, we're not discrediting that. She earned a lot of money for her masters by telling fortunes. She earned a lot of money telling fortunes. She followed Paul and the rest of us, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God, and they've come to tell you how to be saved." This went on day after day, until Paul got so exasperated that he turned and said to the demon within her. Notice he didn't speak to her. He spoke to the demon within her. "I command you in the name of Jesus to come out of her," and instantly left her. Her master's hopes of wealth were now shattered, so they grabbed Paul and Silas and dragged them before the authorities. Now, there's a few things I want you to notice there, because there are many Christians today that look upon demon power as if it's just all fake and goofy. Now, there is a lot of fortune tellings and things that are fake and goofy, but there is a reality of a demonic power to tell fortunes. You say, "Well, Pastor, how can Satan know the future?" He doesn't know the future, but he knows his plans. He doesn't know God's plans. He doesn't know God's destinies, but he knows his plans. So oftentimes, Satan will share his plans. And as he shares his plans for the future and difficult things happen, and people are forewarned about the difficult, horrible things he's going to do because he only comes to steal, kill, and destroy, well, of course, that brings money for people. So the second thing I want you to see is that demonic power can enrich people. So demonic power can foretell the future of what Satan is going to do. Demonic power can also bring wealth to people. Now again, as Christians, we don't like to think about this. We like to pretend that all of that stuff is fake and phony, but it's not. There is a reality of demon power in this world. And Paul confronted it. Now notice, he didn't need to ask this girl's permission to cast the demon out. And notice, he didn't have to ask the permission of the slave girl's owners to cast the demon out. He didn't talk to the girl, and he didn't talk to the owners. He spoke to the demon. Now, when you're dealing with real demonic power, forget the people involved. Speak to the demon. That demon is where the knowledge is coming from, and that demon is where the wealth is coming from. Once that demon is gone, everything changes.